Hi, everybody. Welcome to Valley Views. What you see and what you hear in the Coachella Valley, it has been so busy, as you all know, and it continues to be. There are a couple of events coming up that I wanted to mention to you. The first is the Indian Wells Athena Awards. That's on April 25th. Travis Irwin and Dr. Rose Teherina and Swearingen, I think is her last name. I hope I didn't murder that name. It's on, as I said, the 25th, and the phone number for you to call is not here. Never is when I need it. Yes, it is. 346-7095. 346-7095. And the 24th annual Fire and Ice Red Hot Heart Ball. This is always, always an amazing event. And look at this beautiful invitation, my goodness. This is on, it's actually a week from now, on April 14th, 6 o'clock. And that phone number is 346-8109. And Mitch Blumberg has told me it's going to be wonderful. We would also like to congratulate the DeLucas 65th anniversary celebration during Fashion Week, one of our favorite couples on the planet Earth. And we love you both. Just quickly, we want to tell you a couple things that Bob Hope wanted you to know. On turning 70, he said, "I still chase women, but only downhill." On turning 90, he said, "You know you're getting old when the candles cost more than the cake." Can we have a little laughter? Oh, thank you. Okay, let's see. There was something else I wanted to tell you that he said. Oh, on never winning an Oscar, Bob Hope said, "Welcome to the Academy Awards, or, as it's called at my home, Passover." And on why he chose showbiz for his career. "When I was born, the doctor said to my mother, 'Congratulations, you have an 8-pound ham.'" Love Bob Hope, still to this day and always will. On our show today, we are so happy to have Jay Russell from Jay Russell The Salon, exclamation mark, and Allie. And you know that I wake up looking like this, but in truth, they do kind of help me, so we're going to talk about that. Bruce Fessier is with us. You know him from The Desert Sun, and for, oh my goodness, how many years he has been so wonderful. We have also today a segment that we taped before. It's Kitchen. Jan is amazing, and we're in the kitchen here, and it was so long ago, I don't remember what we made. Does anybody remember what we cooked?
Tomatoes.
Tomatoes, that's tomatoes, right. Yeah. They were wonderful. So hope you can sit back, relax, enjoy Valley Views, and we'll be right back.
Get ready to go wild.
You've got me.
Spotlight 29 Casino presents Dwight Yoakam. One night only. Friday, May 25th at 8 p.m. in the Spotlight 29 Casino Showroom.
Classic hits.
Dwight Yoakam. Tickets are on sale now.
So I blame the
Dwight Yoakam, one night only. Spotlight 29 Casino, the Valley's best bet.
Patty Daly Caruso here for Out of the Box Gold Store, home of the 30-day guarantee. I'm so curious. Tell me about the 30-day guarantee.
Well, Patty, if you sell your items today, and within 30 days, if gold, silver, or platinum goes up, we're going to pay you the difference.
The best price, guaranteed. This takes a lot of the guesswork out. Price goes up, you give me the difference.
I mean, nobody is doing this.
Well, I got to go. I'm going to go home and get all my stuff. Come into Out of the Box Gold Store today, the Valley's premier precious metal dealer. We are so happy to welcome Jay Russell. The Salon means the world to me. Been going there forever and always. And here is the main man, Jay Russell himself, who I love, who has what we call magic fingers, can do things to your hair. Yeah. Yeah. And Allie, so great to have you here.
Thank you.
Yeah, I mean, everybody knows that, you know, I'm just one of those blessed people. I roll out of bed looking like this.
Oh, yes, of course.
It's kind of amazing.
Yeah, the biggest majority of our clients do that. They just roll right out and roll right out.
Like Nancy Tappick.
Exactly. like Nancy Tappick. Yeah. That's a good example.
She always looks like she's ready to step on McCallum's stage.
She takes great care of herself, and we love her for
that. Oh gosh, yeah, we do.
Great person.
But in truth, it's wonderful to have access to so many of you there at the salon who are so talented, can do really great things with hair and makeup. And Smashbox it's so fantastic that that's a line you carry. It's yes. It's like my favorite.
Yes, it is. Yeah. We're so lucky to get it in about a year ago. Mm-hmm. And, you know, it's been doing great. And they've been coming out with some major things ever since Estee Lauder bought it and took over.
Yeah.
So it's awesome.
Well, and we have to say hi to Meg.
Yes.
Hi, Meg.
Hi, Meg.
Meg, who is just worn out from Fashion Week, I'm sure, and running the salon today. Tell us, with the springtime and the summer coming, new looks or what we have to, what we'll be seeing?
You know, it's just like the normal. People come in, they say, what's happening? What are people wearing? We'd really tried to work with staff and putting the look for the client, you know, as anything goes. There really isn't a look. There's nothing that's short or long or whatever. So we tried to gear for summer, fall, darker colors, lighter colors. Mm-hmm. Brighter colors, like what Allie's wearing today.
She said that's new.
It is yesterday. It was just done yesterday. You couldn't put that on a lot of people. And a lot of clients come in and they don't realize that we have that available to do as well.
Uh-huh.
So we can cover every base.
Well, and you know, that's interesting because I have been there and I've watched ladies come in and they do not all walk out looking cookie cutter.
Right.
They really are. It's special for them.
I think that's really the one thing about the salon is we have 60-some stylists in the salon now. And if anyone's not been in, you know, I really would love people to just come by and get a tour of the salon because it is pretty remarkable. And we're going on to our third season now.
Isn't that a third?
Yep. We're excited about that. It just seems like we moved there yesterday.
Yeah.
And so we do have somebody for everybody.
Yeah.
Yeah, we're pretty proud of that.
You ought to be. Mm-hmm. And in makeup.
Yes.
Tell me what's, there's always like lip color and eyeshadow and cheeks and, you know. What's
right now, I mean, the amazing thing for eyeshadows are actually a lot lighter, but pastel, almost Easter looking colors. And then wearing a bright lipstick along with it. So like a bright pink or a bright salmon orange, you know, it's gorgeous. So you pump up the lip, tone down the eye, but it still all blends together in the same family.
Mm-hmm.
It's gorgeous.
It's to me, because I just like red. I feel I would love to wear pale lip colors, but it doesn't feel right to me.
Yeah.
So I think it's a good thing, maybe you can tell me if I'm wrong, when a woman kind of has a feel for how she feels best, what she's wearing.
Oh, yes.
Makes her feel good.
I think Allie would agree with me, I think there's a comfort zone. And people are used to wearing their comfort zone.
Mm-hmm.
So that's why we really try to encourage at least twice a year change. You know, your summer and your fall.
Yeah.
Because basically in the winter months, hair has a tendency to go darker.
Right.
And then in the summer, lighter.
Mm-hmm.
Well, if you're still wearing the darker makeup for a summer look, it's too hard.
Yeah.
And it's
mm-hmm.
not,
yeah.
doesn't give
for
you
sure.
that really soft look of like the lighter clothes and that. So we really try to encourage the change.
Well, like Allie.
At least twice a year.
Well, and like Allie told me about the tinted moisturizer, which will be mm-hmm. so much better in the summertime when you really don't want to wear a lot of makeup.
Right. Yes.
You know, at 115 degrees yeah. or something, to wear a foundation is really kind of difficult to do. So if you can get a great look, a little bit of color, and also protect your skin with the, you know, a nice sun protector.
Yeah.
Sunscreen is the way to go.
Well, and you both know far better than me how wonderful it must be to have Meg and David right there at hand.
Oh. Yeah.
Every day to be sure that everything just moves right along.
We have a great, great team. You know, we've been, Meg, David, and myself have been in partners for, you know, we're 30 years now.
I know.
And we should be having a 30-year anniversary party,
yeah.
I think we'll put that on the calendar. Squeeze that in somewhere in the Fashion
Good.
Week thing. But, no, it's been a great partnership, and we just plan to have some more great years ahead. And some more upcoming activities.
Fantastic. And you know what? You're just a one-stop center because you can do toes and nails and hair and makeup and everything all in one place. So
yes.
A lot of people don't realize we're a full-service
full-service
salon.
We are.
And wonderful. My favorite.
Great. Thank you. We love having you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, guys. And we will be right back.
It's time to trade during the spring sales event at Jessup Chevrolet.
It's where desert drivers go since 1938 to get the most value for their trade-ins.
Get an additional $1,000 trade-in bonus cash when you trade up into a new Chevy with newer technology, superior safety, and better fuel efficiency like the Chevy Volt, Cruze, or Sonic. And getting our lowest price and payment is easy with Smart Shop during Jessup Chevrolet's spring sales event.
Since 1938, the brands you love and the family you trust.
Indulge yourself today at Al Michaels Eterna Salon and Medical Day Spa. We offer everything from laser hair removal, injectable fillers, and skin rejuvenation, specializing in medical and cosmetic aspects of dermatology, using state-of-the-art techniques in diagnosis and treatment of skin conditions. Whether you're looking for professional hair, makeup, nails, tanning, skin and body treatments, let us bring out the beauty in you. Al Michaels Eterna Salon and Medical Day Spa in Indian Wells.
We're so happy to have with us the Desert Sun's favorite personality, voted by the readers here in the Coachella Valley. And you all know him, Bruce Fessier. Bravo.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you.
That's a big, big deal.
Well, it's kind of nice. I've been the also ran for many years. But I have to thank Maggie Downs for retiring.
Maggie Downs, yeah.
Well, actually, she didn't retire. She's now working over at UC Riverside. So
I wondered what happened
in
to
the
her.
Palm Desert branch. So
Yeah, because I used to read her. And you're doing special projects, which mm-hmm. opens another door.
Yeah. It gives me a chance to do a lot of enterprise stuff, and I was just up here, you know, a couple weeks ago. You let me in your gates, and we're doing a big. We did a big story. It ran April 1st on the 50th anniversary of JFK's visit to Palm Desert.
Oh wow!
When he had this little fling with Marilyn Monroe, and
was that up here?
That was right here. Yeah.
Oh, seriously?
Yeah, seriously. Yeah, and now it's commemorated by JFK Trail and, you know, right around the corner from
so
you.
So they named the street after
They named the street
well,
after
Well, I knew that that was the name of the street.
It was some great sex. When they name a street after you know that's great sex. It's an intersection, too, you know.
Bruce. Actually, Ironwood is well known for lots and lots of things, and I've always known that he came up here, you know, a lot.
Yeah.
And Arnold Palmer originally built the golf course. And may I just say thank you for the incredible Easter that you do every year, and my grandkids come and love it. They have a big Easter egg hunt, it's fantastic. They have a little petting zoo, so. Bravo to Ironwood, but that's news to me.
Well, you know, I had no idea there was such debauchery going on here either. Jimmy Van Heusen was their next-door neighbor, and, you know, he was the big whoremeister of the Coachella Valley and New York City, you know.
Really?
So, he was the guy that he lived with a madam in New York, and all the big band musicians would come to him and, you know, for actually, I think, valid reasons. I mean, people like Sinatra got hit with paternity suits. You know, you go to the groupies and you don't know what's going to happen. You know, why not keep your flings to the people who have a professional relationship?
Did you guys invite him today? We're getting a little racy here.
But we'll have Father Lincoln here absolve us all very shortly.
Very soon. We have to pick the one that Father Lincoln did that fits. Forgiveness.
Yeah.
You've interviewed so many people.
Yeah.
Who, if somebody said, who stands out, who would it be?
Well, gosh, the old timers. I mean, because I learned so much from the old timers. I mean, younger guys Josh Homme and even movie stars like George Clooney that I just interviewed and Tom mm-hmm. Hanks, those are great. But there's something about Bob Hope and Frank Sinatra. You know, those guys, you grew up realizing that you saw them on your TV as you're growing up, and then to actually meet them and talk with them. And still, I've never seen anybody who was quite the phenomena that Sinatra was. And,
oh, for sure.
And Paul McCartney came into the Coachella tent just a couple of years ago, and we got a little taste of Beatlemania, you know. I mean, even the reporters, I mean, middle-aged reporters screamed when Paul McCartney walked into the tent, you know, and these are reporters. These are people who deal with the, oh, geez, I'm sorry.
Oh, take it. It might be important.
It's probably my CPA.
But, you know, Paul McCartney, I always loved. And I was at, the Hollywood Bowl when they first came. Mm-hmm. And I will never forget as long as I live because I had a really good seat. Reb Foster was one of the people who brought him over, Bob Eubanks and Reb Foster.
Right.
So I had a great seat, and everyone around me was fainting. But it wasn't any big deal. Somebody would come behind the girl, wave some smelling salts, and the guy in front would, they'd pull her up and move right on.
Jane saw the last performance of the Beatles at Candlestick Park in San Francisco.
My.
And we went to in Liverpool, and it's a little tour, and they have all the highlights of the Beatles' careers. And then there came a video of their last concert at Candlestick Park. And goes, oh, I was there. Jane goes, oh, I was there. And everybody was all of a sudden, oh, you know.
Yeah, that's how it is. And we actually, we talked a little bit about Bob Hope in our open today.
Yeah.
He's just so special. Okay, we appreciate you coming. We know how busy you are. And congratulations on your newest title.
Well, thank you. My newest title.
Newest title. Love to Janie.
Thank you very
much.
Yeah.
And we are going to go to commercial, and then we're going to a kitchen segment that we had done before, and you'll get to see it today. Be right back.
Welcome to Out of the Box Gold Store. If you've got unwanted gold, silver, or platinum, this is the place to go.
Okay, big decision.
Tell me about the whole process, what you do with it.
We do everything right in front of you, and while we're doing this, you're learning and getting an education of how this all works.
Go to a place you can trust.
This one here says 14 carats, so I know this is 14 carat. I have ultrasound machines, water density. We have certified scales.
That's so fantastic. Come into Out of the Box Gold Store today, home of the 30-day guarantee.
From chic to unique, from casual, fun, edgy to elegant, as well as shoes, jewelry, accessories, and hard-to-find gift items. Customer service is top priority at Patiel's Boutique, corner of Cook and Country Club in Palm Desert.
Welcome to Valley View's Kitchen. And we are here with Miss Kitchen herself, Jan Boysden, and Jackie Olden, who once upon a time had me on her cooking show.
That's
so
true.
So now Turnabout's Fair Play.
That's right.
What are we going to be doing today? Or did you take a look at my basil?
That's your basil?
That's my basil.
What have you done with that?
Okay, so what happened was I got a little bitty one.
Yeah.
I don't even remember where I got it, but it died.
Yeah.
And so I read that you have to really submerge into water and keep a lot of water in it. So I thought I'll try again. And there it is.
Well, let me give you a handy hint.
Okay.
The next time you boil pasta or you boil potatoes, strain the water out, save it, and water your plants with it, any plant. And they grow like you can hear them growing at night.
Oh, my. I do like that. I wish it were money.
Yeah. If I figure that out, I'll give you a call, Pat.
Okay, fair enough. What are we going to be making or doing?
Well, I'll tell you what. I'm from Nebraska, and my mother used to grow beefsteak tomatoes like this, you know.
Yep.
And so there's nothing better than a good beefsteak tomato. And most people put their tomatoes in the fridge.
Oh.
No way, Jose. Don't
never.
Do it. Never. And so what we're going to do is we're going to cut them up, and Jan's going to show you how the things that we use in her kitchen, if you will. And then we're going to put a dressing on it, and as you leave it out, you have to leave it out for about 25 minutes after you cut them up. And
yeah.
They're so good, you won't believe it. You're going to get a chance to taste them.
Oh, and gosh.
All the flavors melt.
My grandma had them, too, in her garden.
Oh, yeah. Oh, they just don't grow tomatoes like this.
No, they don't. They do not.
Yeah.
Well, it calls for 8 firm beefsteak tomatoes.
Yeah,
and those are kind of, look at the size of that. Isn't that beautiful?
Oh, it's amazing.
And then it calls for 1/4 cup parsley.
Yeah.
But the best thing about this little gadget right here, this is, I think, your favorite gadget, if I'm not mistaken.
Yeah, when I give a dinner party, I buy those and then put them next to the table on the plates.
Ooh, good
so
idea.
You can take them home. Watch what this does.
Otherwise,
Daddy.
They steal hers anyway. So it's good.
Why not?
You go right up to the core like so with this little gadget and give it one little flick of the wrist. And out comes just the core, leaving the best part of the tomato behind. And this part is yucky. You don't want
holy moly.
Yeah. And it works great on strawberries. It takes the eyes out of potatoes and
pineapple. Yep.
Little guy, he's so cute. Little Sharky from Kitchen Kitchen.
That's right.
And then you're going to take the tomato.
Yes, and now this is another thing that I got at Kitchen Kitchen. Oh. This is actually, Patty, a cheese knife.
I have that.
Do you have it?
Yes, she does.
But
it does
tomatoes better than anything I can think of. Really
somebody took mine, so I had to go get another one.
I have spies
I don't know
that
which
go
my
and do
kids.
That.
It wasn't me.
Okay, so we're going to slice these tomatoes down. I've got so much garlic here on the breadboard.
Can't have too much garlic.
No, right.
And most knives will squish the tomato and push out the inside juice. But the tomato knife with the holes in it and then the fine serrated blade, it doesn't do that. Mm-hmm. It also cuts angel food cake and French bread without mashing it down. And you can cut an onion paper thin. But, of course, when you're cutting an onion, Jackie.
I know. Put them on.
We need our onion goggles.
Oh, my goodness. Look at that.
And these are the new ones from RSVP called the grilling goggles. Because when you go outside and it's smoking away, it keeps your eyes from watering.
Very
cool.
Cutting
up onions. There she goes.
Now, I got to tell you, Patty, these really work. Because you know what? Every time, she's got to have a pair of
them. You need a pair, too.
Yeah, make her wear them. Because you know what? Your whole mascara runs down your face.
Yes. They look glamorous on your body.
Oh, my darling.
And they come in red and pink, too.
Yeah.
And
they really work. They really do.
But these have the flame on it for the grill. But you can also cut the onions with these, too. But those are just something that we've had for a long time that people just love to get as gifts because everybody cries when they cut an onion. So
everybody.
That's the way to prevent it. So now she's cut up the tomatoes.
Mm-hmm.
And you're going to do the parsley now, right?
What I'm going to do is do, see this little blender? I got this at Kitchen Kitchen.
Imagine that.
I don't think there's a thing in this kitchen that didn't come from Kitchen Kitchen.
You're giving me both.
That's right.
And see this little gizmo? It's going to make everything go right. All right, Jan, now I'm going to start putting stuff in here. I'm going to put in a quarter cup of parsley, fresh parsley.
Okay.
Mm.
All right, two garlic cloves.
Okay.
Now, this is one of my favorite tools, too, called the garlic twist. And you actually take the garlic clove. We've already done a little bit ahead of time just so we would have it.
Okay.
But you actually mash that up, give it a little whack, okay? And then you put the inside, after you take off the skin, you put that all inside like so.
Uh-huh.
And then twist. And then you just go back and forth.
Now.
The more you go, the more finer it is. A little less is a little more coarse. So we already did that ahead of time. So that's in here in a little bottle.
Okay.
And then you have salt.
Yeah, a little bit of salt and a little bit of pepper. This is about a teaspoon of salt.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. And a little bit of pepper. Yes, yes.
That makes it good. And then we need the sugar.
A lot of pepper. Yes.
We need the sugar.
A little bit of sugar, yeah.
You guys better hurry, say we have another minute.
Okay,
all right. And
quarter cup olive oil.
Oh, here, let's put in a little bit of a...
2 tablespoons of wine vinegar, and you can use any type you want. I've got some great varieties at Kitchen Kitchen with the pomegranate
flavor
and the Riesling, really good
stuff. Since we only have a minute here, take out 2 teaspoons of that Dijon mustard and put it in there. Did I put the sugar in?
You did.
Yes, you did.
I did
see that.
Okay. Thank you so much.
One. Here.
Keep Grandma Jackie Chef straight. And a little bit of olive oil.
All right.
Now, wait a minute. It's got to have a little bit more jam.
Okay, that looks good. And then we're going to put this top on and blend it with that patented blender bottle.
Yeah.
Okay. Whisk inside.
All right. Mm-hmm. Do it.
Okay.
Do your number.
And then we're going to shake your booty. Oh, that smells so good. Can you smell that? And then what do you do now? Ready to go?
Yeah. Now, what you're going to do is, when I do all of them, you're just going to pour a little over this. Now, the secret is, kids, leave this out for about 25 minutes on your table. Cover it with plastic wrap so the flies don't sit on it, if you got flies.
Yeah.
And let this develop its flavor. Mm. And I don't care what you take off the barbecue, this is to die for. It's that good.
Okay, great. We're going to put that up on our board, right, Mike?
That's right.
The recipe.
All right.
Right here, it's right here.
You guys are awesome.
Thank you.
The Gadget Gal herself, all these nummy nummies, and Jackie.
Hey, Jackie.
Hi, thank you.
My.
Do you have little things underneath that can direct them to our radio show at all? The K-News?
Yeah,
is that a conflict at all?
No.
Okay, because we talked today about Valley View's tonight at 5:30 because we tape today and it airs on Saturday.
Thank you.
And then when we know the date, we're going to really push it when we're
on.
Thank you.
We'll always
talk about your show and everything.
We will.
And it's perfect because they're hearing it that morning and then it'll be easier for them to remember.
Oh, that's great.
Yeah, but we're on from 8 to 10.
What?
Well, We're on 8 to 10 every Saturday morning on KNews 94.3 FM.
On your recipe dial.
Yes.
Or any dye you got.
Yeah.
Okay, you guys. Thank you, thank you.
Thank you, Patty, so much.
Your kitchen is beautiful, just like you.
Thanks so much.
Really. We'll be right back.
Sometimes I think that it's good to be alone, to be by ourselves, to meditate and really enjoy our own company. And frankly, there are times when I love to be alone, just to sit in the car and drive, maybe to spontaneously go somewhere. I think that I have a healthy sense of being alone, of sort of being my own Robinson Crusoe, at least for a while, on my own little island. But it's also important to remember that we are not alone, that we live in community, both here in the Coachella Valley and in the world. And all I need to remind myself of that is to turn on the TV and see very innocent people and children suffering so greatly, and to realize that my little world is only part of my reality, that I live in a very big world full of people far, far less fortunate than I am. So I remind myself, and I think we all have to be reminded, that when we pray, we are praying for all people, whoever and wherever they are. After all, we do not pray, "My Father, who art in heaven." Rather, we pray, "Our Father, who art in heaven." We never pray, "Give me this day my daily bread." We pray, "Give us this day our daily bread." And we may think that our neighbors, or even those we go to church with, are at times pretty much stinkers. But the truth is that we'll be with them in heaven, be with them for all of eternity. For the people of God, we are all one. There are no Robinson Crusoes.
Father Howard Lincoln, thank you so much. My thanks to all my guests today, and I want to say thank you to David at Ralph's on Country Club and Mitchell. I think that Ralph's is great wherever you go, but these two guys have been unbelievable at party time. We hope that you'll be back with us next week. We are going to actually have this show, and then we're going to do two parts of Faith and Begorra. And it might get a little confusing, but I think you're going to really, really enjoy it. So you come on back, and we'll have another good time together. And much love to each and every one of you from all of us at Valley Views. See ya.